Today, I'm going to be showing you how to turn this into this. Hello, I am Leaf from Anything Cameras, the channel that focuses on helping you improve your filming and photography. And today, I'm going to be talking about the key to getting a great green screen key. Setups for green screens are easy. All I'm using are three lights. These can be pretty cheap. They don't have to be super color accurate. That's just personal preference if you want a color accurate light. So, what I do is I just have two lights, one next to me here and one next to me over here, and those lights are shining on the green screen. Those are fully diffused. Now, you gotta make sure that you are standing just in front of these lights so you aren't getting any green light cast onto you. So make sure the lights are diffused and that they're slightly behind you. You don't have to be feet in front of them, you just have to be right in front of them so you're not getting any green shadows on you. So there is a kit that can help you get started that comes with two light stands, two 45 watt bulbs, two umbrellas, and that only costs $40. We're not using that exact kit. We do own it here in the studio, but what we are using are two 90 watt bulbs, which are a little more expensive, but they kick off a little more light, which helps keep that green screen nicely exposed. However, I am using a 45 watt bulb to light me up, which is plenty. And we're using some cheap soft boxes here, here, and one for the key light. Each soft box costs about $20 a piece. So our green screen right here, 20 bucks, and all you need to do is hang the green screen and keep it kind of taut. But I'll get to that in just a second. So back to lighting. I have one key light, and you might be thinking, well, aren't you supposed to have three lights, a key, a fill, and a hair? Well, you can get away with just one light. What I'm doing is just having one key light for lighting up me. My hair light ends up being all the light that reflects off the green screen, hits the back of my head. It kind of defines me. Now, you do not want too much green reflection onto yourself, but you won't get that much if you're just using a regular fabric green screen. It's not going to reflect all that much light onto you. Okay, so as you can see here, I have a light right next to me here and one right next to me here. And you might be thinking, well, how am I gonna key that out if I don't have a green screen across the whole width of the image? Well, it's simple. You just mask this side out and mask this side out in the editor. Now, if you do want to move your arms out like this, as you can see, they're cut off. They disappear into the mask. So just make sure that it's wide enough for you, whatever setup you have, so that if you're flailing your arms left and right, up and down, that they will not get cut off in a mask on the edge of the frame. Now, let's get into hanging this green screen. Basically, you just need to hang it where it's kind of taut. We have a few wrinkles in our green screen, as you can see. It's been bunched up for a while, and that's not a super big deal. As long as you light it up from both sides, one from the left, one from the right, it kind of evens out any shadows that you get. Now, I will suggest that you use the same brand of light bulb and the same power, so one side isn't brighter, and they are both shifted the same amount of color. So say if you have light bulbs that are green shifted or magenta shifted, you don't want to mix a green shifted light bulb with a magenta shifted light bulb, because that'll just make the key that much harder. Okay. So keeping it kind of taut is pretty easy. You can just weight it down at the bottom and hang it kind of taut at the top. You can use clothespins or whatever you need to get it taut. Now let's get into editing this footage. So now, if you don't want to pay for an editor like DaVinci Resolve Studio or Premiere Pro, there are plenty of free editors out there like DaVinci Resolve and HitFilm and many others that can also do this for you. So just find the tool that allows you to key out colors and select the green screen. It's often called ultra key, chroma key, green screen key, something like that. It always has key in the name as far as I've seen. Now, once you get that green screen to disappear, you'll end up with blackness, and you'll probably notice some green fringing around you, the subject. So what you do is go over to the settings, wherever they are in whatever editor you're using, under the keying effect, and mess around with them until you can get rid of most of the green fringing. Now, a background is really easy to get in there. You just throw it on the video track below your green screen video, and once you key out the green screen, Bingo, you got a background. Before you use just any background, some will reveal green fringing a lot more than others. Avoid red backgrounds. You tend to get this super nasty looking green fringing, and it looks kind of Christmassy and just bad. Also, black, really dark colors is not amazing because that bright green shows up pretty well. So keep it lighter. Blues work great. Teal, white, they all look pretty good. White can show up green fringing a little bit worse than other colors, but it's not too bad. So basically anything that's lighter and not red. So now if you're using an image on your background, make sure it's high enough resolution so it doesn't look all pixely and nasty behind the subject, because that just really makes it look super weird when your subject is high resolution but the background is low resolution. It gives a cheap feel to the production quality. All right, all I wanted to do was touch on the basics of how to get a good green screen key. Talked about lighting quick, talked about editing quick. You can go way more into editing green screen video. So that's it from me today, and I will see you in the next video. I'm gonna be talking about the key to get a great green screen.